game has been activated. We are on!
Okay, Cookie, we think we have the scorpion problem under control.
Finally! I can put my shoes back on. Oh my god! Hi, this is Cookie Masterson, and I once played the role of Kristen Stewart on the cover of Us Weekly. I'm glad it's just you and me. I'm feeling a little needy. And your wrong answer of the game is being sponsored by
Optometrix Novelty Eyewear. Our products rarely cause blindness anymore.
Find the wrong answer associated with our sponsor to get yourself some sweet prizes and bonus cash. Okie doke, this is really happening.
Get ready, time for question.
One.
Let's begin with Jodie Foster, the people. I hate it when I like a movie and people are always saying, oh, the book was better, the book was better. Shut up, people. If I wanted to know how good the book was, I would have learned how to read good. Which of these Jodie Foster movies was not based on a book that was better, or any book at all? The Silence of the Lambs, Contact, Maverick, or The Hotel New Hampshire? Allow me. Silence of the Lambs, Contact, and The Hotel New Hampshire were all based on big best-selling books, but Maverick was just based on the old James Garner TV show. And yeah, the TV show is better. But at least it wasn't a book. I think you might need some contacts to see the right answer. Which is why you've won these googly eye contact lenses from Optometrix Novelty Eyewear. Warning, if you put them in backwards, you will rip your eyes out. This wrong answer of the game has earned you $4,000. Don't spend it all in one place. Take a good look at Settlers of Chris Kattan. I love Chris Kattan. Oh, just got a push notification from my fortune cookie app. It appears that I should eat one right now.
Cookie, fortune, cookie, fortune, quest, cookie, fortune, cookie, Masterson.
Well, let's see. Follow your nose. Not bad advice, but which ancient sculpture would find this fortune useless? The Venus de Milo, the Thinker, Michelangelo's David, or the Great Sphinx? The Sphinx is missing its nose, so it would have nothing to follow. If the Sphinx really followed its nose, it would probably find it in a museum on some super advanced alien planet. The signs are everywhere, people. Aliens are real, and they're going to take all our noses. Coming up, when you thought Hal was shallow, and stick your nose firmly in the air for a DisOrDat. I'm going to read off 7 items, and for each one, I want you to tell me if it's a quote from Gwyneth Paltrow or a quote from Mother Teresa. If it's a Gwyneth Paltrow quote, press the left arrow. If it's a Mother Teresa quote, press the right arrow. All right, let's get started. I'd rather smoke crack than eat cheese from a tin. I would rather die than let my kid eat cup of soup. When you don't have anything, then you have everything. I can't pretend to be somebody who makes $25,000 a year. I love anything that comes in a hot dog bun. Words which do not give the light of Christ increase the darkness. When I pass a flowering zucchini plant, my heart skips a beat. Holy mother, that was good. I know sometimes celebrities can seem a little out of touch, but that's only because we're so much richer, better-looking, and well-educated than the rest of you knuckle-dragging Neanderthals. That's all it is. Don't take it so personally. Next up, ye madmen of old. What would you most likely see on Mad Men if it took place during the 1860s? Roger's wedding ruined by Lincoln's assassination, Pete losing an account during the French Revolution, Joan's husband going off to fight in World War I, or Don having an affair with Cleopatra? Abraham Lincoln was assassinated in 1865. The rest of these events are not even close. I would watch 1860s Mad Men just for the wardrobe. I mean, those wool uniforms, that long underwear. Ah, those bonnets. Now, that was a time when people cared about fashion. I call this one, the squeaky turkey gets the grease. Ever had deep-fried turkey? It's kind of like a deep-fried Twinkie, except with turkey instead of Twinkie. Say you're hungry for a greasy turkey. Where's a real place that you could eat one? The Hungry Grease and Turkey Border Point, the Hungry and Turkey Border, the Hungry and Grease Border, or the Grease and Turkey Border. Only Greece and Turkey have a shared border, so you could eat your greasy turkey on the edge of Greece and Turkey. And I find the best way to travel to Turkey is by gravy boat. That brings a close to round one. And surprisingly, you're doing pretty well. Don't forget, all the questions in round two are worth double. Okay, we're bringing it on. Say hello to the cow drove and the swine flu. Yeah, it's bring your pet to work day, and one of the interns brought in an adorable pot-bellied pig. Say hello, Sir Oinkington. He just loves a little sailor outfit I bought for him. And get this, it's so adorable. He loves it when I play this little piggy and count his toes. Too cute. When I count the piggies on Sir Oinkington's pig feet, how far into this little piggy do I get? This little piggy went to market, this little piggy stayed home, this little piggy had roast beef, or this little piggy had none. Pigs are even-toed ungulates like deer and cattle who have four toes on their feet, two functional, two non-functional. So with four toes, you would make it to the fourth verse, this little piggy had none. I just hope my cat's poopsie and mayonnaise don't get jealous of all the attention this little pig is getting. This is both terrifying and adorable.
Question 7. Get up and shake your monkey bang.
Pucker up for Bros Before O's.
It's the put the choices into order, then buzz in and see if you are right. Question.
Get this one right for an extra $1,000. Arrange these things in order from when they were born, from oldest to most recent. Oreos, SpaghettiOs, Jackie Kennedy, Onassis. SpaghettiOs, Oreos, Jackie-O, Jackie-O, Oreos, SpaghettiOs. SpaghettiOs, Jackie-O, Oreos, or Oreos, Jackie-O, SpaghettiOs. Oreos were introduced in 1912, Jackie-O was born in 1929, and SpaghettiOs were invented in 1965. That just earned you an extra $1,000. I love Oreos and SpaghettiOs because I refuse to eat any food that resembles something you can find in nature.
Follow me down to the sea.
Up next, Middle Earth, Down Under, Top to Bottom. You know how Peter Jackson shoots all his incredibly long Lord of the Rings movies in New Zealand? Well, see if you can wrap your crossbow around this. Given how New Zealanders refer to Australia, which fantasy adaptation would be most logical for Peter Jackson to shoot there? Harry Potter and the Prisoner of Azkaban? Bridge to Terabithia? The Wizard of Oz? Or The Wind in the Willows? My New Zealand friend tells me...
G'day!
Yeah, that's him right there. He tells me that down in New Zealand, they refer to Australia as Oz. Get it? Short for Australia. Makes sense to me. Just give Gimli some green stockings and voila! Munchkins! This one's called... June Cleaver is Living a Lie. Suppose fictional housewives from literature started appearing in episodes of Bravo's Real Housewives series. Considering where they live, which pairing would make the most sense? Emma Bovary on The Real Housewives of Atlanta, Anna Karenina on The Real Housewives of Orange County, Connie Chatterley on The Real Housewives of New Jersey, or Daisy Buchanan on The Real Housewives of New York. Daisy Buchanan from The Great Gatsby lives in Long Island, New York, and she's also plenty rich, so she'd fit in great with The Real Housewives there. And since The Great Gatsby takes place during the 1920s, by now Daisy would be nearly as old as the other housewives. Oh, I'm kidding. With all their plastic surgery, they all look like very youthful aliens. Try this on for size. All my exes seceded with Texas. Say Texas finally becomes its own independent country and constructs a fence around its entire border. Considering the states it's touching, what justification would you probably not hear? It'll keep out those dang Louisianans. It'll keep out those freeloading Oklahomans. It'll keep out those golden New Mexicans. Or it'll keep out those shifty Kansans. Louisiana, Oklahoma, and New Mexico all border Texas, but Kansas and its Kansans do not. Texans have a rich history. I mean, remember The Alamo? Starring Dennis Quaid and Billy Bob Thornton? Now that was a movie.
Brace yourself for the attack. When you see two clues that match, press the space bar. 2,000 if you're right, but you lose 2,000 if you're wrong. But keep this in mind.
Remember the clue.
It's gotta be a match that fits this clue. Catching some Z's. Who's the sleepyhead? Good luck.
She wrote. You know what? After all this, I'm actually pretty tired. I think I'm gonna go take a quick cat nap. Oopsie! Mayonnaise, get over here! I need to use you as pillows again! Stop fidgeting, Poopsie. You're only making this harder on yourself.